an album and a car.
Yeah.
I have.
Right, first class out is the upper class of Maidenhead, as the whole team meeting this morning. Super class and a lovely car to win the class, but won it quite easily. The heifer with a fabulous sight profile, the balance, and the way this heifer parades and the style that takes her very comfortably to other class. I thought paraded to perfection by this young man this morning, a really good start to the day. It was the overall balance and length and refinement that took her over this lovely girl.
Thank you.
How are you going?
I'm all right.
Are you going to let it go?
I think it just...
Have you known it cheap up?
This one's got Harry Potter's cloak on.
Winners.
Got an
out
fire.
Okay. This week.
I think it's a fluffy bit on top that they're not keen on.
Yeah. Couldn't stop a pig in a given.
Yeah, couldn't stop a pig in a given. That leg's.
Thank you.
No.
Oh, we have it.
I'll tell you the story about him. The wind has eased completely off of that bit of rain and hopefully it'll pick up a touch. We should still see some nice flying. Originally wild taken from Tanzania and brought into the UK to go into a breeding project. It unfortunately never worked out well. For one very main reason, Arthur here doesn't like conservation projects worldwide due for birds such as Arthur. As he's now what we call a red list endangered species, they're going to need a helping hand. But now and again while doing this type of thing, you will be heckled from the audience. And a lady shouted out to me, "How do you know he doesn't like girls?" I was there at the start, madam. I was involved in the project. But how do you know? I want to know. I thought, you're not going to shut up. I'll tell you. I know Arthur here doesn't like female vultures because he unfortunately ate the first one. 18 months later, trying to eat the second, and 3 years after that, trying to eat the third. If you're eating your breeding partner, madam, it is no longer a conservation project. So instead, this is his job. He will not do a roly-poly, a somersault, or a backflip. He will just fly the best he possibly can, like a great big vulture, in the areas that we give him. And with the wind having now dropped, he's staying kind of close, but we can often send a sneaky second circuit in like this, and push him a touch further away. And he's beautiful at it. But as you can imagine, this is not afternoon weather, so he'll do what he's got to do to get that food from me as easy as possible today. The beautiful pink cheeks and the blue and orange on the beak tells you this bird is a serious thing. A carrion feeder designed to crack open carcass of large animal in the wild. That beak is the business end and very powerful too. So you've got to keep your fingers well away from it. When he's working and he's flying, he glows bright pink and he's excited and happy. I'll try and get quite a bit out of it. It's activistically horrible weather. And like you and I, you don't want to do the gardening in a weather like this. And he's looking like
I wouldn't have won that.
Very funny.
Thank you.
Right. Oh, I'm telling you. My knees have been digging for Mick John Henry. Well, he's so hard to please, and I've been all around this world. Now if you see a rich girl, just pass her on down the line. If you see a rich girl, just pass her on down the line. But if you see a poor girl, won't you ask her to be mine? And I've been all around this world. I'm working on the new railroad with mud up to my knees. Working on the new railroad with mud up to my knees. I've been digging for Big John Henry. Well, he's so hard to please, and I've been all around this world. Well, the new railroad is coming, boys, and the cars are on the track. The new railroad is coming, boys, and the cars are on the track. Well, to my knees, working on the new railroad with mud up to my knees. I've been digging for Big John Henry. Well, he's so hard to please, and I've been all around this world. And I'm working on the new railroad with mud up to my knees. And I'm going around the
Hold on. Oh, Actually, better be nice.
I can do it.
Come back to me, my fella. Here's your hand. After three, I want you to take a bow. Don't go early. One, two, three, go. Okay.
Got any legs? It looks like we've run out of legs.
And one of the most adaptable breeds of cattle in the world. Economical to produce high quality. And following them is the British Blue. Originally the Belgian Blue, the Brits, a specialised meat producer, a prominent double muscling. You can see that from the cow's quarters. Predominantly black, which is red dogs occur. And now we have the British Blonde. Following the Aberdeen Angus, the British Blonde. Pick up that trophy, you've also won the Airedale Beagle Trophy. for the best exhibit owned by a farmer in the Airedale Beagle Country. So congratulations to that. And you've also won the Otley CMA Challenge Trophy for the best exhibitor bred animals. Very well done. If you'd like to come and collect the first trophy and then collect the other two, the Airedale Beagle Trophy and the Otley CMA Challenge Trophy from the secretary to head. Would you like to come forward and Bertrand Parkinson's Memorial Trophy? This is for Alan Lawson. And now moving on to the Alan Lawson Memorial Shield for the highest placed young farmer or young Holstein Club. This goes to Balemore's Seaver Twinkle. And Mr. Seaver, G.W. Coates, and it was fired by R.E.W. Seaver, sorry about that, and it's earned by G.W. and M. Coates and staff. Very well done. And Coates and Sam, they have also won the Crabtree Challenge Trophy for the best exhibit in the Jersey Cattle, only to reside within 15 miles. And this went to Agatha Lottie. And now we're moving on to the Associated Cooperative Creamery. And this trophy awarded for the winner in the Holstein Group Class. And that goes to R&E Butterfield. Congratulations. So very well done. R&E Butterfield winning the Associated Cooperative Creamery Cup winner in the Holstein Group Class. Now we're moving on to the Cornwall Perpetual Challenge Trophy for the best Jersey exhibit. Also won. Double health trophy for the same green dairy shorthorn champion.
Yeah, if you go to the gap there.
And now we're having a great day here at Otley Show. Moving on to the North East British Blonde Trophy for the Supreme British Blonde Champion. Going to Kate McNeil with Kate and Justin. Congratulations to them. This class is sponsored, the British Blonde class sponsored by the Bishops and Veterinary Group. And also Cornford Direct Thieves and Macclesfield Wakefield. So very well done by Mrs. Jane Foster. Congratulations to them, they take home the Shore of Wharfedale trip, champion Hereford. And the next trophy is the North of England Aberdeen Angus Club Trophy. For the best animal in the Aberdeen Angus section, it goes to the Turnbull family. And they also have won the North of England Aberdeen Angus Club Cup. And that's for the best presented animal in the Aberdeen Angus section. The Turnbull family with Bell Lane, Mississippi, Chateau, I think. And the Colin Dykes Memorial Cup for the best exhibit of any other purebred breed goes to G.C. Brown. And that's Chester Brown with his British Blue Trancombe Jubilee Queen. Congratulations to him. And he also wins the Bishopwood Farm Cup for the best sport in any other purebred. So congratulations to them. Two cups to go home with today. A good day out. Some of them too. Bring these wonderful beef and dairy animals before us. Thank you very much indeed. there of this lovely foal. It's by the winning broodmare, Marius Amazing. So just 5.5 months there again, it's been foal. And the next one is the Foal at Loft House Farm for the Junior Shire Champion. Junior Shire Champion goes to Crossington's Tobias, led by Paul Bedford. By Medlingham Hopton Hamlet. This is Crossington's Tobias. Congratulations there to Paul Bedford. With a diamond. And the Signet Trophy goes to the champion in the M&M, the champion by the Morland Large Breed section. Now moving on to the Best Side Trophy. This is for the champion ridden Mountain Moorland. And this is Durka Amazing Grace, earned by Andrew Jackson, ridden by Jonathan Launch. And it's a Welsh section indeed, so congratulations to the ridden Mountain Moorland champion, the Welsh D. Durka Amazing Grace, congratulations. And moving on to the Knight Errant Trophy. And this is Michelle Carroll riding Emily Carroll's Magic. Owned by Hayley Martin and written by Abigail Buckley. So very, very well done. Let's give her a big round of applause. Young jockey here. Congratulations. Very, very well done. Abigail Buckley.
Check it from.
And Harwood Valentine. It's a long way, so thank you very much. Much appreciated. Those are a lot of honour. Quick lot of honour. Let's give them a big round of applause. Congratulations. Very, very well done. Our champion of the Mountain Moorland section. Next to jump number 577 is Tracy Newman with Hughes Pony.
That's it, thank you.
down there for Tracy Newman. Who knew? Of the bees to jump then, number 567, say to me, Laura Stevenson. Unfortunate four faults there, and a good time of 44.20. For number 567, Laura Stevenson and Zayda Mee. Jumping next, 578. 578 is challenge, Tracy Newman. There for Tracy Newman with challenge in a time of 50.89. That brings her into fourth place.